Today we are going to talk about a new topic, that is adjectives. Adjective is a word which qualifies or adds to the meaning of a noun and pronoun. For example, Ram is an honest person. So, Ram is an honest person. So, here the word person is a noun which something added to this meaning is honest. The quality is added to this person is the quality of honesty. Therefore, this is an adjective. Adjective could be used in two different ways. Firstly, it could be used attributively, and secondly, it could be used as predicatively. So here in this particular sentence, when a adjective is used in front of a noun, it is used attributively, because it talks about the quality or attribute of an object, person or a thing. Secondly, we talk about the predicatively. So predicatively, like Sita is wise. In this sentence, wise is the adjective, but it is used at the end of the sentence, not with a noun, but it refers back to the noun. Therefore, it is called subject complement. It relates to the subject. Who is wise? Sita is wise. Therefore, since it relates to the subject, it is called subject complement. Oh, this way of using is called predicatively using. So next we'll talk about the kinds. So there are 8 kinds of adjectives which we will be telling about one by one. First we talk about the quality. So when we talk about the quality, we talk about very clearly of what kind. When we say Rohan is a clever. Rohan is a clever boy. Rohan is a clever boy. So here the word clever is an adjective which talks about the quality of boy or Rohan. So this is called quality adjective. Second one, we talk about quantity. Quantity we will be talking about. We'll talk about how many or how much. Okay, so when we talk about the quantity, we talk about the much, how much. So for example, there is no milk in the pot. There is no milk in the pot. So here word no is an adjective because it comes in front of milk. So it talks about how much. So it talks about the quantity of the thing. So quantity of the milk is no. So here the word no is called the adjective of quantity. So next we'll talk about the quantity of adjective of number. Adjective of number, when we talk about, we say how many of noun and how many of pronoun. For example, there are some boys. There are some boys in the park. There are some boys in the park. So there are some boys in the park. So here word is some. So this is an adjective of number. So we are able to know the number of the noun.
Now, very interesting thing, the same adjective which are sometimes of number and other times they become of quantity. The difference only is that when this adjective is used in front of countable noun, it becomes the adjective of number, and whenever it is used in front of the uncountable noun, so it becomes the adjective of quantity. So, for example, there is some sugar. There is some sugar in the pot. There is some sugar in the pot. So look at these two words. Here, word some is an adjective of number, but on the other hand, here some becomes an adjective of quantity. It all depends which noun they follow. If they follow the noun which is countable, it becomes the adjective of number, and when it follows the noun which is uncountable, the adjective it becomes adjective of quantity. So this is how do we understand that what is noun of quantity and noun of number. That means, so next topic we will talk about the adjective of demonstration, or we call it the demonstrative adjective. To understand what demonstrative is, we need to understand the word demonstrative comes from the Latin word that is demonstrare. Demonstrare means to show. Demonstrare means to show. When we indicate something, when we show something, that is called demonstrative. So there are four kinds of adjective demonstrative, like this, that, these, and those. This we are both used for singular number, and these and those used for the plural number. Whereas this is used for nearness, and that is used for distance. Same way, this is these also used for nearness, and those is used for the distance. Now let's understand this example. This book is mine. This book is mine. Those books are yours. So look at here, which is this book. So this is a singular number. This is used for singular number because singular noun is there. Those are for the plural noun. On the other hand, we say that book. That book is mine. Those books are yours. So that book is mine. Those books are yours. So that used for singular number, those is used for the plural number. So we need to understand what demonstrative is. It indicates. So this and these always will be followed by a noun or pronoun. Noun or pronoun. So we have here books, they are nouns, and they are followed by demonstrative adjective. The next point we'll be talking about possessives. So possessives are actually the noun which normally most adjectives which are mostly confused with the pronouns. For example, his, her, my, your, their. So these are called the possessive adjective. This is his pen. This is possessive adjective because it talks about the possession. Who has the belonging to it, who has the ownership of the pen. Her. That is her book. So again, this thing talks about the possession, the possessiveness, the belongingness of a noun to somebody or something. So this is called the possessive adjective. Last but not the least, we'll be talking about proper adjective. Proper adjectives are the adjectives which actually derived from the proper noun. What is proper noun? Proper noun is the name of a place or name of a person. For example, Gandhiji. So Gandhiji, when we talk about it, is a proper noun. America is another proper noun. India is another proper noun. But these proper nouns, when they are turned into adjectives, they becomes a proper adjective. For example, when we talk about it, Gandhian philosophy. Gandhian philosophy. American people. American people. And Indian culture. So look at here, philosophy is a noun, people is a noun, culture is a noun. But they are followed by some of the adjectives which were actually proper noun, but they have been changed into proper adjectives like Gandhian, American, and Indian. So this is how we conclude that adjectives are very, very important topics to be understood in English language. So let's talk about the definition. So I said it qualifies a noun and pronoun. Then uses, I talked about two uses, that is attributively and predicatively. When they are used in front of the noun is called attributively used, and when they are complement of a subject or of a noun, they are called predicatively used, rather when they come in the place of predicate. Then we talk about the kinds, that is the quality, quantity, number, demonstrative, possessives, and proper adjectives. Hope this will help you to understand adjectives and bit little better way. Hope you will enjoy this video and learn for your better future. Thank you. Have a nice time.